work of a wife.
Basically, you can get a hard copy of whatever the digital data you have. So the most common use of printer is, it is most peripherals, and there it actually print the text and still images on the paper. That is what we mean by, if you really wish a hard copy, most of the times you do need a hard copy. Then for that you have to have this peripheral device. Okay, now if you consider what are the types of printers. Printers are classified basically two types, impact printers and non-impact printers. Whenever I say impact, means there is a certain force which will be given onto the paper so that the proper image or text can be produced on it. Under impact printers, there are two popular printers. One is dot matrix printer, another is called daisy wheel printer. Then dot matrix printer actually prints the dot by dot, or I mean here some needles are activated regularly, and from this needle actually the picture is printed. And from today also it is developed right from 1970, developed by Centronics, and still today we use this particular printer more popularly because cost of the printing is almost negligible. Then another is daisy wheel printer. This is very similar to your typewriter printer, whatever, like typewriter. Whenever you press any key on a typewriter, that particular character is directly impressed onto a paper. On similar line here, daisy wheel printer is like a line printer, where you can print on many number of characters or number of many lines can be printed per second. Or here, and the quality of this daisy wheel printer is much better than dot matrix printer. Effectively, both printers uses the ribbon for printing or having certain impressions on the paper through ribbon only, that actually you get the text or any graphics from by using this printer. Basically, both the printers are textile printers. Then another types of printers comes as a non-impact printer. There is no pressure is applied as such. There are three popular types of printer coming under this, mostly used in the market. Very first is a inkjet printer, where actually ink is pressed or focused, or you may say directed onto your paper. And because of this spray of inks through nozzles of respective colors, you can print a character. Then second printer is most that is thermal printer. This thermal printer is mostly used on it uses the characteristics of some specific paper is required. Mostly you whatever the bus tickets, or maybe like if you go to the mall, and here if you get most of the time the printers used are the thermal printers. Then probably the best printer nowadays, today's available, that is printers, and most almost 90% people use this type of printer because of very good quality, and the day by day the cost of printing is also reducing. So that is why most of the people go for laser printer. Then what are the basic printing functions? So how actually the printing, what are the functions involved in printing process? These are, first you have to receive the data from the PC through an input-output interface. That means through the print port, data is received from PC to the printer. Then this data is stored in the printer RAM. Mostly all the printers have got its own RAM, so that people can work in the background also. I mean, if you do just give a printer, and if you just give the if you just fire the output on a printer, then immediately you can start your working, because printer may take 5 minutes, or it may take 10 hours, it may take 1 hour. But whatever the data, once it is sent to the printer, then printer automatically manages all this printing through it, and for that there is no necessity of CPU for a printer to print the remaining papers or remaining work. Then third, it converts the data into print instructions. So obviously there are certain print instructions. These are routine instructions. Based on the input data available, those print instructions are given through its controller card to actually the printer head, and that automatically continuously works. Then after these print instructions are given, most importantly, it has to feed the paper in and out. It also has to store and dispense the ink or toner. Depending upon the type of printer, if it is inkjet, you'll have to dispense the ink. If it is a laser printer, then it has to dispense the toner. Then similarly, if there is a ribbon dot matrix printer, then it will be mostly using a ribbon. Finally, transfer the image onto the, what will be the image that is being developed, that has to be transferred onto the paper. Of course, this is related to your laser printer only. So these are the 5-6 operations that printing functions involves. Then normally what we use, either we use ink or a toner or what we call as a ribbon. This is, you may say it is a consumables that are required for printing operations. Very first is a liquid ink. It is sprayed onto your paper. Okay, so this is inkjet printer. It is actually sprayed, or through nozzles, it is actually being forced onto the paper. Then another is dry toner. It is transferred to paper with electrical charge and then fused or melted to the paper with the heat. We'll see the detail operation of it. That is how exactly the laser printer operates today only. Then finally, you can have an ink ribbon, that is pins or hammers, the ribbon. That is pin or hammers that strike the ribbon, leaving a mark on the paper behind it. So this is a very tiny nozzles are there, popularly we call as the pins. There can be 9 pins or 24 pins. Just vertically place one above the other, and depending upon the pulse given to it or the signals given to it, automatically it fires. When it fires, it actually hammers, or it imprints its impressions on the ribbon, and because of its force, the from ribbon, that particular character is printed onto your paper. The major advantage of this, it can have a carbon copy or multiple copies can be printed by using this particular concept. Then how you should select a printer, that is, what are the factors that actually evaluate the printer? So if you want to take a printer, what should be then criteria for taking the printers? The very first is what we can say, it is the initial cost. You have to decide what is your budget, for what operations you have to use the printer, and accordingly, most of the times, if you have an initial cost is very high, then probably the life of that printer will be much more. But most of the times, you have to do the compromise between the initial cost and maybe your work. Then most importantly, what is the working cost of the, or what will be the cost of supplies, or what we call as cost of consumables. Then you have to think of what is the ink available, what is the cost of the ink, or what is the cost of the toner, or if there is any special paper that is required for printing. Just like thermal printer, you need to have some specialized printer for carrying out the printing. So you have to also take this into consideration. Then another factor that governs the speed, it delay before printing starts. There should not be any delay, or most of the delay involved should not be more than 30 seconds. Once you fire the printer, fires the printout or any file to be given or to be print on a printer, then your print should start printing it within half an minute. There should not be any delay before printing starts. Then most important specification is pages per minute. That means how many pages can be printed per minute. Normally the specification called as a PPM. There in the market, if you go for laser printer, you can have a 6 pages per minute, or 12 pages, 15 pages, 20 pages. As the requirements increases, that means you are, if you used to go for heavy duty printers, then it is possible 35 or 50 or even 75 pages can be printed per minute. So this is the available. Even nowadays in the market, 100-120 ppm machines are available, printers are available, which actually gives those many printouts per minute. That is why the measured as ppm. Then another is how support is given. It should have a network support, or it can be a wireless support. Either this facility is you required, whether you are to use this as a network printer, or this you want to use as a wireless printer, it is possible. Then additional facilities such as scanning facilities available, folding and stapling. Nowadays, some high heavy duty printers are available. And if you really want to print a certain, say, booklet, that booklet containing certain folds and pins, it is automatically, if it is, you can directly supply A3 paper, or maybe A4 or A3 paper. And if you supply A3 paper, automatically it will be folded as per the requirement, and at the center or at the side, the stapling will be automatically done, and pages will be automatically being printed from 1 to 16. That means even if you have a 16 pages printout and if you wanted to do it by using A3 paper, it is possible that some of the printers are available which automatically folds the paper, which automatically pins the paper, stapling is automatically done, and pages are automatically printed from 1 to 5. And when it comes output, automatically you get the stapled that booklet. It is possible. In fact, these are the advancements in the printers are there today, in today's printers. Then let us say what is the most important factor that you need to know about printer is the DPI. It is a quality, and that quality is called as a dots per square inch. It is called as the print quality. It is measured in dots per inch. That is called as a DPI. Okay, that is dots per inch. Now you can see here 300 DPI or 600 DPI. More the DPI you have, more will be your quality of the printing. Okay, or that means minimum 600 DPI is better for most of the practical printing, whether it is a graphics printout or whether it is, I'll say, the text printout or using certain fonts. 600 DPI is the most reasonable DPI for good type of printing. Then factors for evaluating printers. How you can evaluate the printer based on their facilities. Let us say very first interface, that means how printer is connected to the computer. You can have a parallel connector, that is the 25 pin connector, very old connector now, it has having 25 pins. Then afterwards USB printer is coming into the market. So you can have a USB interface, and with USB cable you can directly transfer the data, which is reasonably faster compared with the parallel printers. Then you can also have a network support, that means you can have RJ45 connector directly going to the printer and network adapter or RJ45 sockets. And then it will be a dedicated printer. Okay, then at the same time you can also have a nowadays wireless printing also. So through Wi-Fi or through Bluetooth you can send your signals to the printers and you can have a printing possible. Then another is paper tray, that is number of sheets or inputs and output, that is how many trays are supported. It is basically useful when you have a large amount of printing. That means when you have a something like 75 ppm machines, 75 pages are printed per minute, so you have to have a very large stack of sheets, and that particular papers you should be stacked one above the other so that printer can automatically shift over from one tray to second tray to third tray, and without any wastage of time it will continuously go on printing. Third is paper feed type. Mostly these are the two types how papers are automatically been passed to the printer. That can be tractor fed or that can be sheet fed. When you say tractor fed, that is normally used in dot matrix print. I'll show you that tractor material. You are aware about it. Then sheet fed means that how many papers can be fed. That is one paper by paper. That is called as the sheet feed mechanism. Then also most of the printers do have extra RAM, or there is a provision for adding some additional RAM into it. And the advantage of more the RAM is that printer speed will increase. At the same time, you can be less bothered. Once your printing is given to the printer, you can start, then you don't need to connect to the computer. Then on itself, it will go on printing till the last printing is there. Then page description language, that is called as a PDL. This is very important. And most of the times here, every printer has got their page description language. This is a typical printer's language. That means how a character should be printed, how certain fonts should be adapted, how certain lines dotted, or maybe any type of special characters or special effects are to be produced. Then that can be produced only by using what is called as a page description language. It is again a typical language. Mostly it is understood by printers only. So there is a controller, there is a soft fonts, there is certain bias, there are certain routines stored into a printer's memory, and that will take care of whatever the data. Once you give the command, rest of the work is automatically be done by printers. Then come to the today I'm going to explain you the two most popular printers. One is dot matrix printer, another is laser printer, and then we'll go for some fault finding related to printer, and maybe on to next lecture on Monday I'll explain you about inkjet printers, and simultaneously I'll cover scanner and their specification and working of scanner. So this is what I decided today. Let's go for an impact printer. As I said, it is a dot matrix printer. So you can see this is a dot matrix printer. Image is also shown. So whatever these are hole like paper. So this is a hole paper. So this is what we normally call as a tractor mechanism, where actually you fix this particular paper into these particular holes, and automatically then when you give the command to this printer, this paper automatically rolls over through this particular tractor, and automatically this head moves from left to right, and automatically it starts printing onto your paper. So this is entirely, this is called as a dot matrix printer. So if you see the picture of this, this is normally called as the head of the printer. Then through this particular portion, actually this is the head part through which actually these pins come out. Then if you see this particular portion, this is called as a ribbon portion. This ribbon is continuously moving. At the same time, this head moves from left to right. This ribbon moves, rotate continuously. And then these nozzles, or what we call the pins, these are immediately strikes onto this particular ribbon. And because of the force of those particular striking on the ribbon, the corresponding color impressions are produced onto the paper. And that is mostly in the form of dots. As the printing is done in the form of dots only, hence it is called as a dot. And it is called as a dot matrix because one character is formed by what is called as a combination of certain characters that we call as a matrix, certain by rows and columns that I'll explain you by with certain figure. Okay, so this is now, if you say this is a control panel on the right of side, there is blue button and some other buttons. And these, through this, you can automatically control, restart, initialize, or configure the printers. These are the control panels for these particular printers. You can remove this particular, you can feed the paper, you can move the paper forward, backward, etc. All this is possible. And as I said, this is the most commonly used printer for a low cost printing. Mostly if you go for the railway reservations on these counters, or most of the times if you really want a low printing with three or three multiple copies using carbon copies or single copy or multiple copies, then mostly this type of printer is used. These printers have a mechanism that touches the paper to create an image. Actually here it touches the paper to create an image. These printers works by banging a print head containing a number of metal pins. As I said, there can be 9 pins or 24 pins, which strikes an ink ribbon placed between the printer head and the paper. So this is the mechanism that is used in a dot matrix printer. So here, this is another picture showing almost the same thing. That is Epson printer I've been having. Then again, mostly remember these printers are available with the two sizes. Normally these papers, printers, if you see, these are 80 column printer or 132 column printer. These are the two popular sizes of the printers. When I say 80 column, that means 80 characters can be printed onto this. So for that particular paper is used, is normally 10 by 15 paper. And that means here you can see that is the height of this paper. Width is normally 10 inch and height is equal to 15 inch. So the height is, sorry, height is 12 inch. Normally 12 inch height is standard, and 10 by 12, if you take, that is a normal portrait paper, you can say. Or if you wanted to go for a very A3 size paper, then that is called as a A3 or 132 column printer. And that is a big size, and almost 132 characters can be printed. Of course, if it's a similar character, but nowadays, this particular printer also has got the support of graphics. And even you can print the graphics, you can print the fonts also. After invention of Windows, once Windows started giving the outputs in the term fonts, then there are corresponding changes are also being done in dot matrix printer design and its overall support. And from 9 pin, most of the times now dot matrix printer is available with 24 pins. With 24 pins, relatively cost is higher, but even you can print certain graphics pictures also. Of course, not a good, not very good quality, but of a desirable, if you can satisfy from this, then it is possible some images, graphics, or even fonts can be printed by using this. But it is restricted to mostly it is used only for a text type of printing where you have to communicate or something, prints are to be done. Then best example I can give you is on the railway registration counters. This is normally used. The term dot matrix refers to the process of placing dots to form an image. Actually, dots are placed with the help of, as I said, with the action of that pins or a nozzles that is coming out through the head, and continuously it is going on striping. Of course, it is controlled through a data that is coming through computer, then in a RAM, and through this RAM, this data is analyzed. It has got its own controller. That is what we call a logic circuit of the printer board. That logic takes the data, put it into this, and this converts into what is called as a PDL language. Once PDL language is converted, then it just goes on giving the proper instructions to the printer, and those instructions, one after the another, it is followed, and automatically, without human intervention, the printing will directly continue. This is the working of dot matrix printer. Its speed is usually 10, 30, 550 characters per second. That means in per second, 30 characters or even 500 characters are possible to print by using this printer. Okay, then this is the cheapest and the most noisy printer. Of course, this is being a dot matrix printer, so there is a noise or a sound created during printing. As I said, it is the cheapest printer available. And as it is cheapest, obviously its quality is low, print quality is there. But still, it was very popular maybe 10, 15 years back. But due to advent of printer technology in the laser field or even inkjet, then this slowly now this is becoming nowadays people do not go for this. But even if you really want to have a very low quality, low cost of the printing, and if you have that type of work, then it is still people do use in most of the offices and organizations. You'll find still dot matrix printers are used because of its inherent feature. These are the two inherent features, that is the cheapest cost printing, cheapest printing that is possible by using this. Only here you have to make major care of its maintenance, that is dust free maintenance, or if you properly maintain that particular printer without any problems, for years together it will go on giving you the printing. And here these dot matrix were first introduced by Centronics in somewhere 1970. Centronics are very popular for their ports. Whatever you use, parallel ports, serial ports, or these ports, these are all ports, D-type ports, printer ports, all these are called Centronics ports, because the Centronics company has developed those particular ports. Then how dot matrix works? The dot matrix forms images one character at a time as the print head moves across the paper. As the print head moves, one by characters are printed. It uses the tiny pins to hit an ink ribbon and the paper, much as the typewriter does. This printer arranges dots to form characters and all kinds of images. As I said, there can be 9 to 24 vertical column pins are connected in a rectangular print head. When print head moves across the paper, pins are activated to form a dotted character image. These printers produce carbon copies along with the original. So that is a major advantage of this printer. Now, if you see, want to see how exactly the characters are formed. So as you can see here, there will be certain rows and columns for any particular character. Some specific area is used, irrespective of it is this. That means it is a uniform printing. Every character is going to occupy certain fixed space. Of course, if it is a proportional font type. Now, there can be certain fixed font type and proportional font type. That is, if Windows fonts are there, if you are printing L characters, or if you are printing M characters, then probably the space occupied by I or small L or capital I or like this. These characters is going to use small space, and then probably W, M, or like these characters will take more space. But when you go for dot matrix printer, it is possible by either using programmatically, it can be done, or there can be a fixed type of fonts. That means it will depend upon what supports it has. If it supports the fonts, then it will give the proportional spacing. Or otherwise, if there is not supporting the fonts, then there will be give the fixed fonts. That means fixed spaces for every character. And this is the one character that is shown here, that how exactly this particular character is printed. That is E character, it will be printed here. From this E character, every time what will happen, as the paper moves horizontally, see vertically some dots will be marked, then immediately after some pins will be fired, then some pins must be fired, then some pin. That means these 9 or 24 pin will continuously goes on firing one after the another. And it, once it fires from left to right, then automatically automatically, there is a program that actuates those particular pins. And one after the another, at a very fast speed, those goes on bombarding, or this goes on hitting your paper or the ribbon, and that goes on producing the impressions on the paper and that particular character. So this is the how actually it prints. And here, very important is the head of the printer. That head is costing almost 1/3 cost of the printer. Even if you go for 2 days over head to go on a purchase in the market, it will may take 5,000 to 6,000, and total cost of the printer could be about 12,000 to 13,000 if it is a 132 column printer. Now also you will find that 2 days in market, if you go for dot matrix printer or 80 column small printer, then its cost will be about 5,000 to 6,000, 7,000 like that. And here and below through this, you will find a laser printers and all these are available. But still, if this is the initial cost, it is very high, but your cost of the printing is going to be very small. Hence, still it is popular in the market. Now, if you say advantage, disadvantage of this matrix, it is in inexpensive dot matrix printer. Page per cost is very, very low. It is energy efficient. Disadvantages are it is noisy. It makes a noise or a sound. It has got a very low resolution because basically it is not for graphics printing. For still or very good quality pictures. It has got low resolution, limited fonts flexibility. That also fonts you may not be able to get. Whatever the font support is there, through there you can read the manual, or you can take the what is called as a print test paper, and from this test paper you'll come to know which type of fonts it supports. Then it has got limited fonts flexibility, poor quality, and of course there is very poor quality graphics out because it is not basically designed for graphics purpose. Let's say now another printer that is non-impact printer. So here this is non-impact printer is basically again this printer creates an image on the print medium without the use of force. That is why we call it a non-impact. They don't touch even the paper while creating an image. Non-impact printers are much quieter. It's very smoothly and silently they are working. Than impact printers, as they don't strike the paper. Okay, let's come to this particular more popular paper printer, that is a laser printer. I have just shown you the picture of this particular one laser printer. There are thousands of printers are available in the market with the certain facilities, maybe with the certain specification, and most of the time, see, all in one facilities are there. That means you can print fax, and at the same time you can send the data also. That means printing is possible, faxing is possible, and scanning is possible. That is called as a all-in-one. All printers are now of this particular category, having certain very small deck is there, inside some mechanism is there. Here is the control panel, then what about top panel, which you can remove from this, and you can scan this, or you can put a paper, you can take a Xerox copy of the paper, or you can print that particular paper, or you can scan the paper, and then accordingly, based on your work, you can complete. So this is a multi-purpose laser printer. Let's say we'll see how laser printer works. Now, how exactly the pictures, how text or images are printed onto the paper. So here in this mega laser printer, paper is fed and the drum rotates. That means we have to feed the paper through your paper tray. It will be automatically taken by your feed paper mechanism feed. Then drum will start rotating. Then once the drum rotates, start a laser beam conveys the information from the computer to the rotating mirror. And the third image is created onto the drum. This is very similar to how you form an image on TV. That is by scanning process. Okay, that means your data, which is in the digital form or RGB form, that takes that particular RGB form and that actually scans entire screen. Now here instead of scanning this entire screen, actually there is a drum, and on this particular drum this entire image is being developed for a specific time. When it rotates, at that time only this image is developed, is created, developed, then printed, then again it is developed, again printed. Most of the times for one type of printing, that means for one printing page of A4 size, maybe of about 11.4 inches by 10 by 12 inches, it takes 3 times the image is formed onto a drum, then it will be printed, again formed, again printed. That is the mechanism it is being controlled through laser beam. the charges on the drum are ionized and the toner sticks to the drum. That means whatever be the drum that is they actually use, drum is ionized, then through this ionized certain charges or potentials are developed, then toners are applied to these particular disc. Then this toner is attracted onto the toner is transferred from the drum to the paper, and then heat is applied and the paper is printed. There are actually six steps and of printing. We'll see in details about these six steps. Let's see that now what are the six steps of a laser printing. The six steps are cleaning. Of course, you have to clean the drum. Once the image is formed, then everything you have to clean and you have to remove the unused toner. Toner is basically, you might have seen a toner. Toner is basically a very black powder. Okay, that particular black powder is filled into a one cartridge that is normally called as a toner cartridge. So first step is cleaning. Second step is cleaning conditioning. That means you have to apply almost -600 volts heat is applied to entire drum. That is called as the conditioning. Then third step is writing. You are actually with the laser beam, you are actually creating that particular image or that particular text onto that particular drum. Then this, once you have applied this, then with this particular writing, then there is a certain developing process. That means where the potentials are low, toner is get attracted onto that particular low potentials. Higher potentials, toner is actually rejected. So whatever be the image, that image is actually formed in the whatever the electronic image formed on the drum, then black image, that is toner, gets attracted onto it and it is developed onto your drum. Then after the image is developed on the drum, then paper is applied. Paper is being at a positive potential. Whatever be the powder or toner that is being on the drum, it gets attracted onto the paper. It is actually transferred onto the paper. Then it is stationary on the paper. As soon as it is transferred onto the paper, immediately the certain fusing is done, that is high temperature is applied through certain rod, and automatically that black powder gets melted onto the paper and it fixed onto the paper, and automatically it gets printed. In other words, it gets printed onto the paper and immediately paper comes out. Let's see what are these particular six steps with the better diagrams. Let us say very first step is now cleaning. Now you can see here how your drum gets clean. So this is a circular portion, you may say it is a drum. This drum is clean either by using cleaning blade or a sweeping blade. At the same time, it can be used a sweeping strip. So this is actually cleaning the drum and removing any unused, if it is any bad part or some particles or unused toner is there, it is actually being cleaned by the first process, that is called as a cleaning process. Let's see what is the second process. Second process is called as a charging or conditioning. What is done here, once it is simultaneously when it is cleaned, immediately the erase lamp, this lamp is erasing all the images on this, and at the same time through the charging or primary corona, it applies almost -600 voltages to this particular drum. That means once it starts rotating, it is not only cleaned, automatically it is erased. At the same time voltages are applied to this, and there can be almost -600 voltages are applied to this particular process. That is called a charging or a conditioning, and this -600 voltage is applied through this charging primary corona, which is having -600 volts. Let's say second stage you have understood that now on a drum there is a -600 volts. Now third step is a writing step. That means here this is a scanning process. This scanning has to be done onto the drum. Then how it is done, it will based upon the how, what is your digital data. So digital data is there, that is digital language is there, PDL language, that is formatted. Then there is a DC controller. It actually starts scanning this particular mirror. So this is a laser beam. Laser beam, it is focused through this focus lens. Then this beam is made very sharp. And after this beam sharp, it actually scans the entire drum, and then this drum scanning is very fast, and that is under control from the data. Whatever the data, this digital data is actually converted into in the image form, one line by line. As I said, it's very similar to the operation of TV. So instead of entire screen here on a drum circular portion, this image is formed. That means here what will happen? Initially your drums, now if you see this particular drum, this drum is minus 600 volt. But now when you strike this particular beam, it takes it, wherever this strikes, wherever this laser beam strikes, there the charge goes to minus 100 volt. Where laser strikes, wherever a laser strikes, voltage will become minus 100. And whenever unprotected area or where the portion where you don't want to print, their laser beam will not strike. So ultimately it will remain as potential on minus 600 volts. The very fourth step is the developing stage. As I said, in developing, you have to apply the toner to your drum. Now see, this is a toner. So this is a box toner. What we say, it is a powder coating material. And through this toner is coming slightly, this is the opening of the toner. Now when this drum rotates at that time, see, this is at a minus 300 volt potential, right? Now whenever it is at this is minus 300 potential, it is minus 600 potential. What will happen? Because of this, wherever the laser beam strikes, it is at minus 100 volt. It is minus 300. So obviously, there is a potential difference between toner and this charge. So this toner will be applied only where actually laser beam strikes. Now this toner will not be placed onto this drum wherever it is at minus 6, because it will repel this. Because it is at minus 600 volt, it is minus 300 volt. So this toner will be repelled wherever laser beam do not strike. But wherever the laser beam strike, their potential or ionization here potential becomes minus 100 volt. So obviously this toner will be. So in other words, there will be image form on this particular developer, or what we call as the drum. On this drum, there is a developer. On this developer, image will be formed of a black particles and wherever the laser beam strikes. So this is the fourth step. Now in the fifth step, see here. Now fifth step, I'll explain you by using. This is a transferring stage. See, this is the, now this is your roller or what we call as a drum. Now what is happening here? Whenever it is rotating, let us say it is rotating, at that time automatically, because now this is a paper. This is paper is at a positive potential more than now. What will say, when I say positive potential, automatically what will, because of the positive potential, whatever be the particles were deposited onto your drum because of the laser beam action and some toner, that toner will be there. So that toner will automatically transferred onto the paper, or it will be attracted onto the paper, because paper is at positive potential. Your drum is at minus 100 volts. So this paper, it will automatically drop onto the paper. As soon as it is dropped, it is pressed. Okay. And not only pressed, but as it is goes through this simultaneously, the sixth action, that means transferring means your particles which are deposited onto your drum, it automatically transferred onto the paper. Then once it is transferred on the paper, it is immediately pressed and it is passed through the fuser, that is very high temperature roller. And because of this high temperature, this powder automatically melts and fix it on the paper, and your printing is completed and paper comes out. So if you see this particular action, this action happens many number of times. So this is one sample example I have taken, that how exactly printing takes place. So this conclusively, so this is the tip transferring action. Fusing roller apply both the pressure and heat to the paper. Then the toner melts and rolls paper, the toner into paper, effacing the paper. So this is nothing but, this is what I'll say, this is fusing action and this is actually transferring action. Okay, I think this is fusing is the last step. I have made a mistake, I'll correct it. This is the sixth step, that is fusing step, and this is the fifth step, that is the transferring step. Let us say these are the six stages. Again, I'll explain you all in brief. First stage is cleaning, that actually cleans the unused toner. Second stage is conditioning, which applies the minus 600 volt to the drum. Then next stage is writing from laser beam through mirror. It is actually the entire picture is painted electronically or certain with minus 100 volts. Wherever the laser beam strikes onto the drum, that picture is developed. But that picture is just an electronic picture. That picture gets a black form by using what is called as this developer stage, where particles are actually impregnated or a pinch, or you can say these particles are attracted onto this ionic form, and then the image is developed in the form of what is called as a toner in the fourth stage. In fifth stage, transfer stage, the particles which are deposited on the toner, because of the laser potential of the paper, this is get attracted onto this particular paper. See, this is actually fitting. Now, if you this the particular portion here, this phyllo, you will find actually these particles are deposited onto the paper. Simultaneously, this is pressed onto the paper. And when it is coming out here, the fusing action starts over here. It gives the paper, it is a hot, and that is actually melted. These particular particles are melted onto the paper, and it gets fixed onto the paper and gets printed, and then this paper comes out. So these are the six steps. These are common steps in using a laser printer. Then what are printer configurations options? So this is orientation. Either you can have a portrait orientation or landscape orientation. Collation is there. That means when you print a copy, you can have an option collate or uncollated. Collated means if you have 10 copies of 100 pages each, then it will print 1 to 100 first copy, then again second time 1 to 100 second copy, like that. But if you this way, it can print 10 copies. But if you say uncollated, then it will print the one page 10 times, then second page 10 times, three page 10 times, like that. That is called as a uncollated printing. Then it options are there, whether you want to print one entire set from 1 to 100 pages, or whether you want to print one page first, then second page, third page, it will be decided by collated or uncollated. Then copies, you can get number of copies, whatever you want. Then quality, that is option for draft, whether you want a draft printing, normal printing, or very high quality printing of printers, you can decide the DPI of the printer. That is, my settings are there. Through these settings, you can decide what were the output quality. Mostly, 600 or 1200 DPI is more than sufficient for most of the laser printing options. Then printer configurations options are there. Color, you can specify color, black and white print. Of course, if you have a color laser printer, then there will be three toners will be used, or three, and here cyan, magenta, and blue. Cyan, yellow, and magenta. These are the three popular colors used. Sometimes RGB are used, but for printing purposes, mostly cyan, yellow, and magenta colors are used for getting this. And from these three colors, any complementary colors are developed. Then orders, some printers allow you to specify whether to print from last page to first page, or first page to last page, or some specific printer, or maybe from 1 to 10, then 12, then 15, or maybe 15 to 16. That means in any order, in any way, it is possible to do the print. Or even you can also print what is called as a current page. It is possible to print. Then you can switch between print and prints. You can switching between print is also possible. You can also spool the setting. That means you can drive, you can give certain set, you can decide the settings from where it can be, or you through software also you can send this particular settings. Some configuration can be done through buttons on printer itself. Some manual printers are option there. Certain settings are there. You can operate through buttons also. Then mostly, what are the advantages and disadvantages of these? So advantages are most commonly used as laser printer. It is very high quality. So color and monochrome, that is both black and white color possible. And it has got a very high quality printing, very high resolution, energy efficient. Then many options to select. There are many ways that the printer properties are there through software as well as through hardware. You can select the most of the operations. It is available in different PPM, as I said, per page, per pages per minute, that is PPM. Available with the different sizes. It can support a postcard size. Even it can support A4 size, A3 size, and relative. Any custom sizes printings are possible, like legal pages and all. Disadvantage that here it is expensive printing. Relatively, it is expensive because you have to compromise with the quality of the printing. Then laser printer interfaces are, you can have a parallel, now it is outdated. Even SCSI, small computer system interfaces, is there, but now again this is outdated because of the low cost USB. Then serial transmission is also possible. USB transmission also is possible. Even we have seen FireWire ports can be there, just like USB. You can have a similar IEEE 1395 wire or FireWire ports are available. Nowadays, you can have wireless or wireless Ethernet network are there, that is network printers. Or sometimes even printers do have infrared ports also, so that wireless printing can be possible. So these are the different interfaces that printers are coming with. Almost printer has got, nowadays common interfaces are USB and wireless. These are the two most important interfaces that is being used. Whenever you go for purchasing any printer, you have to ensure that whether there's a network support is there or USB printing is there. And most of the times it may have a higher wire support. Then we'll come to what are the different problems that might occur in a printer. So very first is the stalled queue. That means if there is, when you give the printers, then you will find that the earlier printers are earlier, the current page doesn't give the printer, but whatever the earlier printout, earlier, I'll say copy, which is sent on a printer, it's get printing unless it is finished. So here in this case, you have to know that how to select a job, how to resume a job, how to cancel a printing, how to restart the printing, or how to pause a printing, or how to delete the printed job and make RAM empty completely, and then restart the printer and then give the printout. So that there can be a problem of stalled queue because of the queues. All the printers are normally queued in one, like first in, first out. So whether in this way that queue works. So in that case, if earlier unwanted printings are to be stopped, then you have to clear your queue. Then junk characters in a printout, that means specific characters or random characters you are getting. So better you power off printer off, see that if it is not hot, then clear the queue. If there is a queue, you clear the queue. Power printer on and try it again. If still problem persists, you can reinstall the printer driver. Then paper jam. Paper jam can be many times. Fan paper before inserting in a tray. आपण जे म्हणतो ना हाताने चाळून घ्या पेपर त्याला म्हणतात फॅन पेपर्स, म्हणजे थोडेसे त्याला एकापासून थोडेसे डिले करा, चाळून घ्या, नंतर त्या ट्रे मध्ये टाका. देन चेक द फीड रोलर्स, सी दॅट रोलर्स आर जॅम्ड, वन ओनली ऍट अ टाइम वन पेपर इज पास थ्रू दॅट पर्टिक्युलर फीड रोलर्स. चेक फॉर ऑब्स्ट्रक्शन इन साइड द प्रिंटर. मोस्टली दिस इज द प्रॉब्लेम बिकॉज ऑफ सर्टन printing. This is the more problem, troubleshooting. The paper jams is always because of some bits of papers are there, or some obstructions are there, mechanical obstructions, or you have to remove those papers or even a small bit of paper, because that becomes a double and that will not allow you to paper smoothly pass through your mechanism. So check obstructions for inside a printer. There are various facility. Automatic detection is also there. It also tells you the various trades you have to go. It also tells through diagrammatically where that particular paper is being jammed. You can go to that particular tray, you can remove the paper, you can remove certain jams or some bits of paper, and you can clear this and again restart this. And automatically, if everything clears, then it's restart the printing. Use different weight of paper. That is normally what weight of paper means, GSM of the paper. Normally to print, I suggest you should have at least 70, 75, 80 GSM paper. If this is a normal use, but if you go for 50, 60 GSM, that will be very light, and because of this, you can have a more problems in printing. So it is better you should have at least 70 to 80 GSM of the paper to print. Then illegal operation or general protection faults. Pause and resume print queue. That is, if you have got illegal operations or some general problems are there, you just pause and resume the print queue. Restart, if the problem persists, you restart the computer, remove and restart the printer driver. So these are the some probable solutions to this. Then if printout is faint in some spots, that means if there is a faint in, that means you don't have a toner, or toner is some in portion, it is not sufficient. So just shake the toner cartridge gently. Whenever the toner comes at the end, at that time this particular problem is there. In some faint it becomes the faint spots are there. So just shake the toner cartridge gently. Replace the toner cartridge. If you feel that it is entirely been used, now after shaking also it is giving the same printer, that means definitely toner is finished in the cartridge. So better replace the toner cartridge. Lose or smear toner check the fuser. That means if there is a loose or smear, to that means some black powder is spread onto your printouts. That means there is a certain problem with the fuser. That fuser is not melting properly and that is not sticking up onto the paper. So check your fuser in such a problems. Vertical white streaks are there. That means there is a corona, dirty coronavirus. That means coronavirus is not working properly. Then there will be a vertical white stripes will be there onto this. There can be gray mist onto your. So here this is again gray mist. That means there is a dark shade येते तुमच्या paper वरती. So that the gray mist is dirty coronavirus. Or print density set is too high. If you set the density too high, or if drum life is over, then it is also possible that drum needs a replacement. Then horizontal black lines or dirty or damaged a roller. If the roller is damaged or dirty, then you can get this particular problem. Regularly spaced blotches. If you find certain dots are regularly coming, that means there is a certain scratches or your drum is dirty. Because that is getting developed regularly on one page. If the same problem appears two or three times again and again, definitely there is a certain scratches or dirty, or there is a dirty drum. That means you need to re-clean your or replace your drum. All white page, if nothing prints on this, then transfer corona broken. That means whatever the corona that is being transferred, then he had, if everything white is there, that means no transfer of black particles onto page, or printer is completely out of toner. If there is no toner, then everywhere you will get a printout. So that is because of, if you get all white paper, that means if you put a white paper inside and if you are getting white paper outside, that means probably printer maybe might be working perfectly. But if there is no toner, nothing, no powders will come out, no melting, no printing, nothing printing, and that is why the paper will remain as it is. All black page, primary corona broken. If entire page is black, that means there is a primary corona broken. That means it is not scanning laser being perfectly. Drum not holding a charge. It is possible if drum is not holding a charge, then in that case it is possible that you can get an entire black page. So these stripes are one color missing. Clean inkjets using printer's utility, run printer self-test. If you have some stripes are there or one color is missing, then you can always, this is a self-test, is the best test of a printer. It is applicable to your dot matrix, even laser printer. If you get a test printer out, test print out exactly, that means there is no problem with the printer. Then there is a problem with the communication between computers through network or maybe ports or like that. So that is self-test. Every printer gives the self-test, and that is the actually the support. It also gives the quality, the font supports and the toner cartridge, toner quality, everything you get it from a self-test. So it is better to, if you have got any problems with the printer, you better, you, there is a certain settings on the printer. You can automatically get a printer test by pressing certain buttons onto your printer. You can get a self-test. Then colors of align. Of course, you have to run the printer alignment utility. It will take care of this. So this is all about today's lecture that I have decided to cover. So here in this today's lecture, I have just introduced you what is printer, what are the functions of the printer, and what are the basic types of the printer, impact and non-impact type printers. Then we have considered two major printers. Under impact printers, we have considered dot matrix printer, its operations, their advantages, disadvantages. Then we went for another most popular printer, that is a laser printer, which is nowadays mostly used everywhere, and the cost of printing is becoming very slow down now. As we have said, there are six stages of the printing. So these six stages, we here, what we said here is clear. So first we have to clearing, which is the one stage. Second is the conditioning stage. Then if you go for third, that is the writing stage. Then fourth is your conditioning stage. Fifth is transferring stage. And sixth is fusioning stage. So these are the six steps that are normally employed. And there are certain common problems that are available. Then what are the interfaces and some common problems that we discuss related mostly the laser printers, from the output quality or certain these symptoms, you can definitely judge what is the problem with the printer. So this is all about today's lecture. On Monday, I'll go for this inkjet printer as well as scanner, and we'll go for some specifications with the printer, because whenever you are purchasing any scanner or printer or something like this, you should know at least the terms or meaning of those particular words. So this will cover in the next lecture. So here, this is all about today's lecture. So if you have got any problems, you can ask me. Do you have any problems? Any questions? No questions as usual. Yeah.